All right, so if you're like me, you have a much higher chance of actually doing something, especially something new in technology, if it's very easy to do. So watch, I'm gonna show you how easy it is to take questions you already have done and turn them into the new drag and drop or drop down questions. Then I'll show you how to make them from scratch, but you're gonna see both are incredibly easy. So watch. So if you have this kind of multiple choice question already, what's great is that what we've done in quizzes is you just go up to here and choose one of the new question types. And just like that, it'll turn it into a drag and drop question or a drop down question. And so they can just simply drag the answer there. So like at a click of a button, it takes like 2 seconds to do. But if you want to make it, I would say like a true drag and drop or drop down, which the whole point of them really is to be like higher level thinking and have kind of multiple answers in there. This is again, an easier way to do this. I'm just going to use this math problem. So instead of 12 times 2 equals 24, because this is still multiple choice, essentially just kind of glorified, you can go over here. And you hit this add blank button. All right, so 12 times, I'm gonna say 2. And now what's gonna happen is the student now has to pull in both of these answers at the same time. So 12 times something equals something. And they have to look here and figure out, okay, 12 times what could equal this, right? And then they can figure out the 2 and 24. So now, again, in a matter of seconds, we've just turned this regular old multiple choice question into a higher level kind of question. And so now let me show you in case you do want to create it from scratch, because you'll see, it's really easy as well. Okay, so to make a new question from scratch, just simply go to new question and choose one of the options, right? Easy peasy. And let me just show you. So let's just say we're gonna do like a science question about the symbol of a certain element, right? So the symbol of, let's say gold is AU is what I wanna show people. So I do the symbol of blank, gold, and then I would say is, and then put in all your right answers, AU, right? And then all you do is you include any other options you might wanna put here. So silver, and then something else that doesn't match silver. So let's just say H for an example. And so now when they do this, again, in a matter of seconds, the symbol of this is this. So they have to figure out that the symbol of gold is a U. If you can make a multiple choice question, you can make a drag and drop, and you're gonna see there's a lot of value, especially if you're preparing for standardized tests and helping kids feel prepared and less anxious when they get to the real questions on the test.